Hi, I'm so glad you joined me today for another edition of Learn to Livestream with Miss Eileen. Thanks so much for coming out today. I want to go over a question that came in, and you may recognize this young lady who asked the question. She's actually my online mentor. And as soon as I figure out how to show it, there you go. And the question came in from Lisa Irby. And it was from the last video I did, which was 5 live streaming apps for iPhone. And Lisa asked, "Hey Eileen, are you excited about Facebook's new built-in screen share feature? I know I am a few days late on this, but thought of you when I heard about it." I love that, Lisa. Thank you. "I'm looking forward to using it on my 5 private student group. It's nice to cut out the middleman. I'm testing it out on one of my dummy pages with no followers to see how it works. Not bad so far. I'd love to see a video on what you think of it. Your wish is my command." So here we are over on one of my Facebook groups. That's similar to what Lisa said. It's a pretty much private group. And, you know, I don't really have any, I use it for testing. That's the best way to describe this group. And so what I'd like to do is just show you what I think is a positive about it. And pretty much it's like Lisa said, you eliminate the middleman. So let's do that. And what happens for the very first time when you do this, you're going to have that ability there to set up your webcam. As you can see, I'm using the Logitech C920 webcam, but it gives me the other choices there, which FaceTime, I definitely don't want to use that cam. And you probably don't as well. Then let's skip screen share. We'll come back to that. Then I'm using my external microphone. I always recommend that when you're doing any type of live streaming, you want to use an external microphone. The one I'm using is the ATR2100. And you can see a complete list of all the gear I recommend over at eileensmith.com/gear. And I'll make sure I put a YouTube card here so you can check that out. So we're going to make sure that we select our external microphone. And the first thing I want to let you know before you hit the screen share button, it's going to prompt you to install a Chrome extension. Facebook has their own Chrome extension for screen sharing. Now, of course, I'm on Chrome. I'm going to assume that they have one for the other browsers as well, but let's just stick to Chrome for now. And it's just simple. You just go over and it'll pop up and then you just say add to Chrome. That's it. Easy peasy. Okay. So we don't even have to show that part. So now here's the caveat to using the native Facebook screen share. When you screen share, you will not be able to do picture in picture. So the only thing people will see is your screen. They won't see you at all in your webcam. So once you choose screen share, that's what folks are going to see. So that's kind of up to you. If you want to use the native Facebook app, that's pretty much what you're going to be left with. So let's just pick that option. And in this case, I'm going to share my entire screen. I'm not sure how well that's going to go. Yeah. So we have a bunch of busyness there when I do it that way. And that's okay. So you guys can see the process. And so now I'm going to go live. Now, typically, I would fill in a title and all that. But just for the sake of me sharing this with you, I did not fill in a title. And I wish I would have planned this out a little bit better, but at least you got a chance to see. Now, down at the bottom, it does say invite friends, but that just means for you to go out and invite your friends to come and watch the broadcast. So I'm going to end that basically because I think that is pretty much it that covers what the screen sharing looks like. Now, of course, you have the option to just click the done or you can delete the video. Now, this is just in a test group of mine, so I don't really have to delete the video. I'll just say done. Now, had there been anyone there, let's refresh the page. And they were commenting that I would have saw those comments to come up over on the side. So there you have it. That's how to use the native screen sharing option on. Wait a minute. Hang on, guys. Let me get myself. There you go. That was getting a little confusing. So that's how you use the native screen sharing option on Facebook Live. So let's just go over it quickly. You'll be able to go live and screen share from your profile, from any of your pages, any of the groups that you're an admin or that you have posting options for, you'll be able to go live and do a screen share. The bad or the downside of it is you can't switch. So once you choose screen share, you're locked into that for the entire live stream. You can't turn off the screen share now and go back and choose webcam. You're pretty much stuck with screen share and you can't do the picture in picture. That's the way I'm understanding it right now. And guess what? As soon as that changes or as soon as I hear anything different, I will be around to let you know. Now, with that, there is another tool that I would love to show off. And I'm actually using that tool right now, and that's EcammLive, and it's for Mac only. So I'm going to come back in a few minutes with another video to show how to use EcammLive. So if you're on YouTube watching now, stick around. And if you're watching the replay, make sure you look for the EcammLive beta video. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next video, which is going to be really shortly if you're watching live.